All right, now we're going to show you how to take diameter measurements, which is really measuring bone breadth or width. So bone to bone, we're going to use an anthropometer. This is a large one, you can see it. We're going to put the tips of the anthropometer on bony landmarks. I'm going to squeeze in and then take my measurement. So I'm going to read where the red line is on the anthropometer. First measurement we're going to take is biochromial. So for biochromial, I need to palpate the acromion processes. Ideally, you want to do this with no clothing over those points. I'm going to put my anthropometer tips right on those bony processes. Keep your index fingers right there. I can squeeze in using my forearm, and I'm going to read the measurement, and that is 36.7 centimeters. Then I'm going to go to the next measurement, which is biiliac. I'm going to need to palpate the iliac crest. So Cristina has her arms folded across her chest. These are measured from behind. As I measure this, sorry, it's usually more anterior than you realize. Again, loose-fitting clothing, or sorry, tight-fitting clothing for this measurement. I'm going to put that right on the iliac crest. Squeeze in. Anthropometer is pointing downward, and I can take my measurement, 27.7 centimeters. Okay, for the bitrochanteric, we're going to measure from the greater trochanters. You want to palpate those. If you need to help identifying that, she can rotate her leg in and out, or she can abduct it and adduct it. Okay, this one is going to need pretty firm pressure. I need to compress the overlying tissue. Keep my index fingers right there. The anthropometer is horizontal or level. Squeeze in, and I can take my reading, which looks to be 31.7 centimeters. All right, for the knee, the client can either be seated with the hip and the ankle flexed to 90 degrees, or we can put her foot up on a stool. On all the limb measurements, it's always the right side of the body. That's the standardized side. I need to palpate the medial and lateral epicondyles. If I'm not sure, she can flex and extend her leg a little bit. There we go, where it pivots. I put the anthropometer right at those points. I squeeze in. And I have about 8.5 centimeters. For the ankle, I'm going to stand behind my client. I'm going to palpate the medial and lateral malleoli of the ankle. I'm going to have Cristina step on the stool. That's not absolutely necessary, but it makes it easier for me to measure it. Shoes off, sock pulled down. I'm going to identify those bony landmarks. Measure it, I get 6.0 centimeters. All right, we're going to go to the upper arm. We're going to get the elbow and then the wrist. So, elbow is in this position so that I can palpate the medial and lateral epicondyles. If I'm not sure, she flexes and extends and I can feel the pivot point. Perfect. From the front, I identify those bony landmarks. I put the anthropometer tips right there. I squeeze in until it doesn't move, and I have 5.4 centimeters. Last measurement is going to be the wrist. For the wrist, I need to palpate the styloid processes. So her arm is going to have palm down. If her palm was up, I would not be able to identify them as easily. So palm down or pronated. I bring the anthropometer tips right to those points. I squeeze in, and I get 4.3 centimeters.